Under Kotlin data types, we are going to discuss these double and float number types. The double data type is double precision 64-bit floating point representation, and the float data type is single precision, that is 32-bit floating point representation. We know that in case of floating point representation, they are following IEEE 754 floating point format. So, for the better understanding, let us discuss them with one practical example. So, here is the practical demonstration for you. Now, in this program, we shall discuss double and float data types. So, let me write one code for it. So, here is the code for us. Here we have defined two variables. One is the double var, another one is the float var. Double var has been initialized with a value 12.34, and float var has got initialized with 12.5, and if we write only 12.5, then it will be treated as a double. So that's why we have written f at the end. So that's why this float var has become of the type float in that case. Okay, now see, in this way, if you go for control shift p, you are finding this one, that it is of the type float. So now if we execute the code, then we shall get the required output. So here is the output for us. We are getting this 12.34 and 12.5 as well. We can also have another kind of declaration. So like we are going for say data, and we are treating this one as type number. We are treating this one as type number. Okay. Now see, in future, if you keep data with the value 12, if you put data with the value 12, then we know that this particular data has got the value integer here. So it is of the type 12, it is having the value 12. So if you go for this control shift P, we are getting this data, and data is equal to 12 here. So now if I print its value, so now here you see, this is the code. So var data colon number, so it is of the type number. When you are assigning 12, then this data will be treated as of type integer. When you are assigning some float, the data can hold that one also, it can get printed. If we assign any long data, then data can hold and it can get printed, can be operated on different expressions. And whenever you are putting any double content, then data can also hold that one. So in this way, we have defined this data of the type number. As we are going to put different values on this data variable, so instead of writing val, we should be writing here var. So if we go for execution, we are going to get the required output here. Here is the respective output for us. So 12.34 has got printed, 12.5 has got printed, then 12 has got printed, 12.34 as a float data got printed, 100 as long has got printed, and 22.33 as double has got printed. So in this way, I have got my required output, desired output from my program execution. So I think now the conception is clear regarding these double and float data types. Thanks for watching this video.